guys, this is the next installment of my systems building video. I forgot to record the sound last time, so I'm doing a little narrative right now, looking at what I was doing on the actual video recording. So this video will be about placing asteroid fields as well as nebulas. So I think where I go to first here is the Kohat system file. I open that up, and also what I like to do is I use Coruscant once again as a base, using the information that's there for making the asteroid field. So you can see I just put the two side by side. You can see that I'm putting in a new tagline here called asteroids. This must be done if you want any type of asteroid field to be put in, as well as nebula. If you want a nebula to put in, which I do later. So there's two components to this tag. The first is the file tag. What this is a link to the actual file for the asteroids, and this is where you can specify a lot of the nitty-gritty stuff. And as you can't really do that with inside the system file itself. And then you also have to have a zone component as well. Zone component is more related to what you actually do in the system file. So I'm just putting that in right there, and see where I go from there. Really important note is to make sure the spelling is always right. If not, this will cause instant crash to your system. So make sure you always do the spelling properly. All I'm doing here is just changing the file and the zone to be the same thing. I like to do that. It keeps everything easier to remember. I tend to put asteroid and nebula tag information at the end of a system file near the jump. What do you call it again? The jump boost. There you go. So, anyways, what I was doing here is looking down at the Coruscant information, and what's really great is this, you can just copy and paste the information, just change the things you want to. So I'm just going to use this asteroid belt here. You'll see that there's an exclusion zone there, which I'll get into at another point. These are areas of where you can specify to the computer that you don't want anything there. So for example, if you go to tattoo, you'll see that I have these big line fields, one with a sphere of mines, and inside there's nothing there, and that's because of the exclusion zone. So anyways, what I do here is I cut and pasted the zone information into the Kohat system file. What you can do with the zones is you see that there's the nickname, and that must correspond to the zone information you put underneath the asteroid tag at the beginning of the system file. Also, with the asteroids and mines, because of the way the systems are set up and some of the preconditioned set points in the game, you can't place an asteroid field any further than 250 kilometers from the radius of the center, or you won't get any type of static information. So what I'm doing here, I think, is looking for the particular type of music. Yeah, particular type of music that I want to play in each zone. Each zone can have its own music. As soon as you enter, the track will change into the music that you want to see here. Now it's just a stock freelancer song. Yeah, I guess you call it music clip. And they're actually pretty cool. So I tend to put those music, the ambiance, I guess you could call it, into the zones to just add a little more flavor to the area. So here I was just trying to find out where it is in the sound files here. So I was trying to see if it's either in the sound INE, which I didn't seem to be able to find it, or if it was in the music I need. Which I don't think I was able to find it in as well, unfortunately. Okay. Yeah, I was just trying to find it right here. I think I ended up finding it in another file. Anyways, what I was showing here is just that the, that's when I go into the asteroid belt within Coruscant, I have that, the music playing there. Ah, see, that's where I found it. It was in the ambient sounds I need. Good place for, like, considering the file. It was named the same thing. So, I'll just go back and make sure that the tag is right. And I think it was. It's called Zone Filled Ice. And so looking at also the zone, you can have a variety of different shapes. You can have ellipsoid, sphere, cylinder, and box, is what I'm familiar with. However, for Freelancer Explorer purposes, it only can really read a sphere, box, and ellipsoid. It can't read cylinder. So if you want to edit anything, for example, exclusion zones, you tend to want to do those in a box, so you can move those around, and then I'll show that on another date when I get to exclusion zones and how those work. So, what else do I be doing here? Right, I'm just right here is want to change the make sure that the zones match to each other. So, the zone equals here is also at the nickname for the zone down here. That's really important. Once again, if you don't do that, the system will crash on you, unfortunately. Okay, so I want to change the size of the actual zone itself, so it's XYZ, or Z, as Canadians like to say. So I made that about 80 kilometers in the west-east direction, and I made it 80 kilometers in the up and down in the plane direction, and 100 kilometers in the north-south direction. Now, property flags are important for what it looks like on the system map when you pull it up. You can have a variety of different system flags. This one here is specifically for asteroids. However, for example, if you wanted it in a minefield, it would be a different flag, and I don't have those off by hand. But what I did was just decrypt the old Freelancer files and see what they flagged their zones by. And I think the, for example, the system flag for Nebulas is that 32768, and that will allow you to add a different color to it. And I think at this point I decided I would add a nebula to the system. Anyways, there's the asteroid tags, and see, there's a nebula tag, which is to add if you want a nebula, of course. So I don't know what I'm doing right now. So there's a little more information in the nebula tags which you can put in. I'm assuming you can put them the same way for the asteroids, but I tend to not. You can see that to have an ID name, so you can name it when it comes up on the system app. You scroll over your mouse, and the name will pop up. I have a music playing, that ambiance thing, the positioning of it. Now you can place nebulas wherever you want in the system, so you don't have to worry about that. And rotate, you can rotate in a specific way if you want to, in the shape, because again I made an ellipsoid. And the property flag, fog color, that's what the color will show up on the map. So you want to change that usually to equal the same values you plug in for the nebula color itself. Interference, this is if you want your radar efficiency to drop, so you put that in. Damage, you can have like a damaging radioactive effect within the nebula. I haven't played too much with the values, so I don't know a good increment for it, but 100, you can always toy around with that later. space dust is the certain types of materials that come out in the nebula. You can have a variety of different things, and I think I get that later, into that later in the tutorial itself. So I think at this point I decided to actually put the nebula in, or I'll show you what the property flag was for the mine, which I think I'm doing right here. Yeah, so the property flag for the mine tag is 4128, and you can see that I changed here the shape as a box, because that was a lot easier to work with, as once again Freelancer Explorer could read cylinder. So it worked equally as well, and it was a lot easier to muck around with the actual dimensions of it. It took me about 10 hours to do that raceway. And you see I changed the dust to be debris dust. It's a little bit different in the number of space particles you see. Now, exclusion zones have their own property flags, which is a little bit different. I think I've explained those enough. But I'll explain them a little bit more on how to use them in another tutorial when I get to that. So anyways, going back to quad here, I'm going to change that, keep the property flag the same because I want it to come up as an asteroid. I think I'm happy with the size here, and visit equals one, once again, let's make sure that when you go into the system it will come up. And here I was trying to bug temp for the proper red, blue, green color for the for the nebula, I think at that point. You can use a paint program. Photoshop is pretty good, apparently. However, I don't have that on me, and I just like to use temp because it's really good with colors. So usually it gives me something pretty nice. So anyways, moving along here. Sort, I have no idea what it does. I just have always kept it in, so recommend you do the same as well, although I don't know what happened if you did take it out. So you can tell me what it actually does. That'd be great, because I have no clue. So anyways, I copy this nebula information, and place it, the tag, at the very beginning of the system file. And really, you can place them anywhere, it doesn't really matter where you put tags, but this is where I like to organize it, where I have the system info, the texture panel, the music that it plays, the ambient, so that would be ambient light, and of all that system identifying stuff at the beginning, and then the asteroid and nebula stuff near the end of the system file. So at this point I just am lazy, and kind of my redundant nature is where I go back to the system file and I just cut and paste information and change what I need to change. So change that to the Quad Nebula, and I'll change that music to the Zone Ice Fields, but they're the same. And then the ID names I'll have to change later. So for now, I just put one. I think I change it later in the tutorial anyway, so it doesn't really matter. Change the name, change the positioning. You want to make sure the positioning matches. Real important. Rotation doesn't matter. I kept it in there for the hell of it. The ellipsoid shape, once again, is something I want. I just want the nebula to be a little bit larger than the actual asteroid field itself. So I'll just keep it there like that. And the property flags, which I've already explained what they are. And the property fog color I'll have to change later so it comes up on the map properly. And I took all that damaging dust and interference out because this will be a starting system for civilians. So it's easier if you just don't have that information. Now for space dust, there's a certain file. Which I'm trying to find here. It's actually called space underscore ALEINE. And I'll get to that in a moment. That has all the different things you can place into as a space dust. So for example, the cool lighting effect I have in Horset, that's because I use this ALE file. And I use the Outer Sanctum lightning. And that actually came from Aldebaran's 1.68 work. I started tinkering with it a little bit more. I think he actually had it around the Spectre home base, and I continued to use that in Horset. Actually, once we get the Sith Academy, Shadow Academy in the game, it actually looked pretty cool with the zone of lightning around it. Anyways, what I'm trying to do here, I think, is I'm trying to find the proper space dust I want to use. It's just called ice dust for this case. And it comes up as little ice particles in here. And you can see there's a whole variety of different things there. So I think that file is decrypted for you guys, but if not, I'll send it your way and you guys can poke through it at some point. It's pretty neat, and I found a lot of cool effects there. The atmosphere effect I have around all the planets is because of that as well. So anyways, I'm just trying to get the ID name for it now. Just putting that name in, saving it. Hopefully you guys have this file out of this program. If you don't, I'll post it up for you guys. Just tell me, let me know. Alright, I'm going to put that information in there. And you can put that information in for the asteroid field if you want. It doesn't really matter, it's your call. In this case, I like to keep the things named, well, the name the same thing and make sure that the game is happy with my zone. So I usually like to put an IDS name there. I'm not quite sure what I'm doing here. Alright, now I'm actually adding the files to the solar component, solar file. So remember, at the very beginning of the tag, you have a file equals component, and this is where it will lead to. And now there's a variety of different asteroid combinations you can use, and I'll get to that in a little bit. So all you need to do is just make a new file and make sure it's named the same. So I think this one's called Quad Ice Field Ironing. Kind of after I type something in. Oh, see, I found the error there. I did type IND. So it's always good to kind of review your work as you're going through. Alright. So I'm just going to cut and paste this into that tag extension just to make sure I didn't have any spelling mistakes. You can have spelling mistakes as long as you keep the spelling mistake consistent throughout the file. So, there's a little pearl for you guys. Now I'm going to do the same thing and make a new nebula. Now, the reason why I structured the asteroid folder and the nebula folder a little bit differently is because I had so many asteroid fields for a few of the systems, and I just wanted to keep them in one file. That way it would be too confusing. But while the nebulas only had one extra. We had one nebula per system, or some cases two for Horoset, and I decided just to keep that information there. Now what I'm showing you is that there's a variety of different nebula types you can use, from generic exterior to Walker exterior to there's a variety of ones. If you actually flip through the nebula files, you can see them all, and it has all that information there. Some important, some more important than others, some less. I think I'll get through that. I'll get into that when I get more into the actual Quad Nebula. So I'm just going to cut and paste that. I reuse the nebula information to the particular nebulas I liked. The generic cloud was actually pretty cool. I used that in Aldebaran, and I like the way that looked. However, there's different types, obviously. Feel free to play around with it. We unfortunately got a new texture for the nebulas itself from the Shatter Worlds mod. The developer there allowed me to use his nebula, and all this information there is because of him. And the reason why they're so pretty is because of him. So I have to give him I have to remember to put him in the credits and a link to his mod later on in the process. Anyways, so I think I'm just describing what's going on here. So texture panels, those are has to be the same usually of the exterior shape. So you see the generic exterior one will equal the generic shapes I need. So the exterior, this is what it looks like on the outside. There's all these different shapes. the bit radiuses, those are things, are those little clouds that puff out. The properties are how the game reads it, so it's known as a nebula there. Nebulite is what happens to the sunlight when you get through it, when you get into it, rather. The sun burn through intensity, it's about as a percentage. So if you want more sun to come in, you put a higher number. Less sun to come in, you put a lower number. Now the sunburn through scalar is a multiplication factor. So for example, if you put 20 and then you times that by 5, you'll have a sunburn through intensity of 100. I don't really know why they did that, but they did. So clouds, this is what you actually see inside the nebula itself. There's puffs, that's what they call them, and that's what they essentially are. If you look, there's different color puffs when you're actually in the nebula. There's a puff color A and puff color B, and you specify that with red, blue, green scaling system. And the radius, you can define the radius of them, the amount of them, the max distance apart from them, and the drift of them. I don't actually even know what the drift is. I think I was just toying with some numbers here, which I always like to do, just to kind of figure out how things work. And I recommend you guys do the same too. Find some cool things to look inside. Now the fog, that's what you actually see on the outside. So if you want to specify the outside color, you want to change the fog color in near and distance. And what that means is how far you can see. So in the distance, and then how far you can see close to you. A little bit obvious, but a little bit confusing actually. If you, for example, made that 5,000 meters, you can't see objects 5,000 meters away from you, but the distance, you can still see kind of objects further away if they can shine through, if that makes any sense. It's, yeah, don't worry about it really. You can once again toy with that and learn how that works by yourself. So dynamic lightning, to be honest, I've never had this tag work properly, and I don't know what the difference is between the lightning, the background lightning, and I've changed numbers a lot. And I still haven't figured it out, so basically I kind of try to keep them similar to one another. So the gap is the duration between lightning strikes, or you see the lightning in the background. The duration is for how long it lasts for. The color is once again the color that they are. So I'm trying to show you here the aurora septum, when I use that special effect, and that's called the outer septum lightning effect. I put that in the space dust component, and that's what comes up with all that cool dynamic lightning, which I quite liked, and added a nice little effect into the Sith system there. Okay. Once again, I have to thank Elder Baron for that, because that was his idea. I was reading his code, I tried it out, and I really liked that effect, and it had the special music there too. If you go into that nebula, you hear that cool lightning effect going on. So, I think I'm pretty much good with my nebula folder here. I think I was waiting for Temp to give me the right colors, and I'll come back to that later. And I'm just going to save that. Alright, now I want to get to the asteroid field. Go back into the solar folder in the tau file. So, once again, I reuse information. What I was trying to find, though, you'll see that each asteroid field has its own components. So, rock shake, for example, is for a asteroid-type thing. Since I was making an ice field, I had to use different data. So, I'll have to actually end up going to another file after this one, because it's not the right data that I wanted. So yeah, texture file. I think I'll go to the stock Freelancer data. I think I have all encrypted, or rather, Elder Baron had all encrypted in this 1.68 folder. So I'm gonna go there and try to find that. And I was trying to find the specific file here, or specific identifying data for the ice. was named a little bit differently than the way I have. I had it more of a freelancer type thing, and I've kind of made it more simpler. Rather, I've made it simpler. The naming and identification of folders. I'm just trying to find the data here, so you can definitely skim a bit in the head here. I'm just going to kind of keep quiet through this. So this isn't the data I wanted, because it's just the lock shape stuff. You see the exclusion zones there. Even you can exclusion zone, you have to place it inside the nebula, as rather the astral folder as well. So the game knows where you want your exclusion zone. But I'll get into that another later date, just to tell you what that's going on there. Now, field, cube size, this is important. This is to show how many objects you want in a given area. Now you can specify this with fill distance. The fill distance is how many, how far around your ship you can see the objects. Now a lower cube size will mean that a lower one it will mean that you'll have more of these static asteroids in your viewpoint. And a higher one means you'll have less. Now because the way I set it up is that I like to have a lot of, you can see this field that goes on for quite some time. I have a larger cube size as a result to accommodate that I want more objects in a given space. Now if I had it at 400, the game will slow down because it has so many objects there that it has to render, and you'll see a performance loss. So find a nice balance there, it takes some time. Ambient color and ambient increase in empty cube frequency. So sometimes you can play with that, for example, if you want a percentage. So so 50%, or actually rather, 50%, yeah. I haven't played with that data too much, actually, think about it, so I'm not going to tell you there. So I think it's percentage. That could either be 50% or what it reads is 0.5, so every 100 cubes that it fills in, one be empty, I think. Anyways, dynamic asteroids are the ones that you see flying around you, flying close to you. Placement radius and placement offset, this is where they'll usually come in at angles at you. Max velocity, I like to make it a little bit faster, so you see these things whizzing by you, it's pretty cool. Max angular velocity is how they spin. And color shift, I have no blood idea what that means. Now, excuse me. For pollutable zone, you have to program that in the actual system file as well. And you have to have, it's called population underscore type, and you put, I think it's pollutable, but let's see here. Originally I thought it was in the Dantooine file, but it wasn't there. Type in this case, it's an non-legal asteroid field, and you specify the game that, to tell the game that. So, for example, in Endor, it's called lootable underscore field, and you want to put that in the Quad system file, so the game knows that you want loot to come out when you shoot these. Shoot the dynamic asteroids. If for whatever reason, like the visit, like at the bottom of every zone, it's one of my little neurotic things. So, in the lootable zone, you can specify what container comes out and what comes out inside the container. Now that is linked into your equipment file, into your, let's see here, when I open it up, that's not right. it's, yeah, now I was trying to figure out where the hell it... Right, so the commodities are specified in your goods folder, so if you want a commodity to come up in your goods folder, if you want a commodity to come up, it must be specified within your goods folder. Asteroid loot and asteroid loot difficulty. The higher that number is, the less likely you will have loot come out. And the more that number is, the more likely you have loot go out. So I think that's a percentage. Dev actually told me about this one time, and I just forgot exactly what it means. But from my understanding, the lower the number of the asteroid loot difficulty, the more often loot will be dropped. And the higher the number, less often loot will be dropped. Just property flags. This is telling me again that this is an ice object, and this is telling me what kind of density is in there. I think that's all that data there. And I actually ended up deleting that x-axis, y-axis, z-axis rotation crap. Didn't need it. So you can remove that when you do asteroid fields. See this, but later on I got all the data from temp to put in the right red, blue, green stuff. And, looked at that. It's just making sure where the texture files, where are they located, and actually found out that they're stock files, so you just can leave that without the tile there, and that will still come up properly, because as long as the person has installed Freelancer, they'll have that file. Right there. place that into the fog color. Now, here I was just trying to figure out where the color was supposed to go. It's been a little while, so that's why I kind of forgot. And anyways, but it goes into the fog. The color goes there. And then for the different puff colors, you put the colors in the puff color A and puff color B. That color in there, that red, blue, green data in the system folder as well, so that on the map it comes out the same color when you open it up. Getting the pop colors here. Minefields is a very similar thing, and also Nebula.